Hello students, this is another explanation video of from your book Snowflakes, which is chapter number 5, The Battle of Blenheim, which is a poem, and it is written by Robert Southey. So let's start the poem. It was a summer evening. Old Caspar's work was done and he before his cottage door was sitting in the sun, and by him spotted on the green his little grandchild Wilhelmine. So here it was a summer evening, okay, summer evening, and on that evening old Caspar, he has completed all his work, okay, and after completing his work he was sitting before his cottage door. Cottage means his house door, you can say baranda, okay. He was sitting before his cottage door and was sitting in the sun, okay, and by him in the green grass, okay, and by him in the green grass his little grandchild Wilhelmine, she was there. She may be playing something, okay, in the field or something like that, okay. Now second stanza, she saw her brother Peterkin roll something large and round, which he beside the rivulet in playing there had found. He came to ask where what he had found that was so large and smooth and round. So Wilhelmine means old Caspar's grandchild. She saw her brother Peterkin, okay, he holds something which is large and round. He's rolling something, he's holding and rolling something round object, okay, and which he got near the rivulet. Rivulet means stream, you can say river, okay, and in playing there had found. So he was playing near the river, playing near the stream. So near that stream he found something large and round object. He came to ask what he had found. Then after he came to that is Peterkin, he came to ask to old Caspar that what he had found. He did not identify the object, that what that round object is that was so large and smooth also and round also, okay. Then old Caspar took it from the boy, who stood expectant by, and then the old man shook his head and with a natural sigh, "This is some poor fellow's skull," said he, "who fell in the great victory." So as Peterkin, he came by holding the round object, he came to his grandfather and he asked his grandfather that what is this, okay, because he could not identify the object. At a time old Caspar, he was also standing nearby both the children, and then after he shook his head down, he shaked his head and with a deep breath then he said that this round object is the skull. Skull, I think all of you know, na khopri. This object, this round object is the skull of some poor fellow who fell in the great victory, means who died in a great victory. Great victory means there may happen at one time, there may happen a war, okay, so in that war many men and women they died, okay, so that is why he said that who died in the great victory. So this is the skull of some poor fellow. I find them in the garden, and for there is many hereabout, and often when I go to plough, the ploughshares turn them out. For many thousand men, said he, we are slain in that great victory. He said that I also found him. Old Caspar said that in the garden there, whenever I go to plough the garden, whenever I go to plough the soil, at a time you will find out many skull like this, okay. And he again said that for many thousand men they were died in that great victory. So there are many skulls are there beneath the soil, okay. So old Caspar told like that to his grandchild. So grandchild Peterkin, he found only one skull, and old Caspar said that there are many skulls are there, like thousand men and women, they had lost their life in that great victory, they died in that great victory. So there are many skulls like that lying beneath the soil. Let's move to next page. Now tell us what it was all about, young Peterkin, he cries. while little Wilhelmine looks up with wonder-waiting eyes. Now tell us all about the war and what they killed each other for. Then Peter King, he asked his grandfather to tell everything about that war. He asked his grandfather to tell him that what that war is all about, what that victory is all about. Then little Wilhelmine, she is also looking at his at her grandfather with wonder-waiting eyes. Means she also wanted him to answer Peterkin's answer Peterkin's question. Means she also wanted to know about the war, about that victory. Now tell us all about the war and what they killed each other for. So both of the child, they wanted, both of the grandchild, they wanted to know about the war and they wanted to know the reason why each people, means why these people, they killed each other for. Then after Caspar cried, means he said, it was the English who put the French to rout. But what they killed each other for, I could not well make out. But everybody said, quoth he, that it was a famous victory. Then the old Caspar, he started to tell about the war. He said that it was the English, means the English people, they put the French to rout. Rout means in that war, the English people, they defeated the French people. Okay. And but what they killed each other for, I could not well make out. Then I said that for what purpose they started the war, for what purpose they killed each other, that reason I cannot make out. Means that reason I cannot exactly say to you. But everybody said, but as everybody say from that time, everybody say that this it was a famous victory. So actually it is a war of Spanish succession, okay, in which the English, they successfully defeated the French people, okay, that is the Bavarian army. So this is all about that war, okay. So that's why Caspar told that it was the English who defeated the French. But for what purpose the war started, the what purpose the war strike out, he also cannot find out the reason. But as everybody, it is a word of everybody's mouth, like everybody used to say that it was a famous victory. So he also, old Caspar also used to say that it was a famous victory. Now let's move to the next stanza. My father lived at Blenheim then, yon little stream hard by. They burnt his dwelling to the ground and he was forced to fly. So with his wife and child he fled, nor had he where to rest his head. So old Caspar, he told about that war, that when the war was happening, at a time he was a little child, okay, so his parents, they faced the wall. So he said that my father lived at, during that war, my father, old Caspar's father, my father lived at Blenheim then. At a time my father used to live at Blenheim, and where they used to live, they live near the stream, okay. They burned his dwelling to the ground. So the French, they means the French soldiers, they burned his dwelling, they burned their houses, okay, to the ground. They burned their houses and all the families, like old Caspar's father, mother and old Caspar. At the time old Caspar was a little child, so all are forced to move out from that place. Forced to fly means all are forced to leave that place. So with his wife and child he fled. So with his wife means old Caspar mother, and old Caspar his father, means all the three of them, they have to leave the place. And nor had he where to rest his head. And after that they don't have any place to rest their head, means they don't have any shelter after there, okay. With fire and sword the country round. So everywhere fire, everywhere people are killing each other by using the sword, okay. War was wasted far and wide. So not only a small place, they captured a large area. They captured a large area of place. So everywhere there is fire, they are burning the houses, they are killing each other, they are fighting with the sword. And many a childing mother means a small, those mother who are having the babies with them. So many childing mother, the newborn baby, they had died in that war. But thing like that, you know, must be at every famous victory. Then old Caspar say that whenever there is a victory, famous victory is there, in every famous victory, these things are very, very common. These all things actually happen. So he said that, but things like that, you know, must be at every famous victory. Then only a war, someone will get a victory. The next stanza, they say it was a shocking sight after the field was won, for many thousand bodies here lay rotting in the sun. But things like that, you know, must be after a famous victory. Then he said, old Caspar said that the people used to say that it was a shocking sight after the war, when the war was over. After the war, the scenario of the overall places was very, very shocking. Okay, because many thousand bodies, they are laying here and there. They are rotting in the sun. Rotting means sarna. Okay, they are rotting in the sun. But again, old Caspar say, old Caspar means it is said by the people earlier. So that's why Caspar also used to say to his grandchild that in thing like that, in a war like that, it usually happens. It is a common thing which usually happen in each and every war, especially when there is a famous victory. Okay. Great praise the Duke of Marlborough's won, and our good Prince Eugen. Why, it was a very wicked thing, said little Wilhelmine. Nay, nay, my little girl, quoth he, it was a famous victory. So as all of the people used to say after that war, everyone used to praise the Duke of Marlborough. Duke means prince, king, you can say. So after that war, everyone praised the King of Marlborough. King of Marlborough was an English general and a commander of the British forces, okay, who won over the French. So everyone praised the Duke of Marlborough, okay, for his famous victory, and their good prince Eugen, okay. Then after, Wilhelmine said that why it was a very wicked thing, that why such a bad thing happened. Okay, wicked means bad thing, evil thing happened. Then after, old Caspar said, no, no, it is not a wicked thing, it was a famous victory. So he always quote the same word, it was a famous victory, it was a famous victory. Why the old Caspar used to say? Because from the childhood, from when he was a small child, from that time he also heard the same thing, that it was a famous victory. Okay. But for what purpose this famous victory was happened, for what purpose that war was happened, no one knows. And everybody praised the Duke who did this great fight win, and what good came of it at last, quote little Petter King. Why, that I cannot tell, said he, but it was a famous victory. So old Caspar, he used to say that everybody praised the Duke. So after that war, after that victory, everybody appreciated the Duke, the king, okay, who won the fight, okay, who won the war. Then after, Petter King said that what good comes out of such misery. Yes, this is a misery, miserable thing, that what good comes out of such a misery, means such a war, okay, what good comes out from that. Then after, Petter King said that why, that I cannot tell, that why and what comes out from that war, that I cannot tell, but I can only say that it was a great, or it was a famous victory. Means the old Caspar, he sticks to his illogical belief that the war brought victory to them, the war brought victory to the country of the people, to the countrymen. So that only he knows, that only he learned, and that only he is saying to his grandchild. Okay, that is an illogical belief, that he also don't know the proper reason of the war, that why it happened, why it started, for what purpose, for what reason. Just the people of that place, they know that it was a famous victory. Okay, so this is all about the Battle of Blenheim. I hope you understand the poem. So till today this much, thank you.